Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here from RoboDK. This tutorial series will cover the basics of RoboDK software. You will learn everything you need to know to be up and running with our tool. This video complements the online documentation that we offer. With this first series, you will learn to create your own robotic cell. You will also learn how to navigate through our interface, import robot and basic objects, and run simulations. Future series will go further, showing you how to do things like generating real robot programs, connecting to the robot, using our tool for robot machining and 3D printing, and creating your own script using our API. Okay, let's get to work. The first thing to do if you want to use RoboDK software is to download it from our website. Let's open Google Chrome, or any other internet browser for that matter, and type robodk.com. You will end up on our website. From there, you can click on Download at the top of the page. On our download page, you can select the version of RoboDK that suits your needs. Versions are available for Windows, Mac, Linux, and Android users. In my case, the Windows 64-bit version is appropriate. The download should not take long. Once it's done, you can go through the installation process. Now that RoboDK is installed on my personal computer, I can go on my desktop and double-click the RoboDK shortcut to launch the software. RoboDK's interface is pretty simple. At the top of the screen, you have the main menu. We will explore those options later. Just below, you have your toolbar. Those are the tools we will use at first to build simple stations. The rest of the screen will be used as our working environment. One important thing to remember is that if you have any problem with a tool in RoboDK, you can always bring your mouse on top of it and press F1. By doing so, you will launch the online documentation relative to the tool you were pointing at with your mouse. F1 is pretty much the help key. In this case, my mouse was over the empty working area. Considering that, the F1 key opened the basic guide. Okay, let's go back to RoboDK. And let's click on the folder icon in the toolbar. This will open the RoboDK's local library. If I go down, I can select the example basic cell. You should find the same station in your computer. And if I click open, the example basic cell will be uploaded in RoboDK. This station is composed of an ABB robot and a simple tool. In the upper left corner of your screen, you can see the station tree. It presents the objects in your station and the relations between those objects. Here, we can see the robot, its base reference frame, and its tool. Okay, let's see how we can manipulate the software interface. First, you can see the three arrows cluster here, there, and there. Those are coordinate systems in the 3D space. They can either represent a reference frame, a target, or a tool center point, commonly called TCP. These are very useful to help your robot navigate in the three dimensions. We will come back to that later, but for the moment, you should know that you can change their size by either clicking View in the main menu and clicking Make Reference Frames Smaller and Make Reference Frames Bigger. Or either by using the plus and minus key on your keyboard. You can also hide the name of the station's component by clicking View and clicking Show/Hide text on the screen. The keyboard shortcut for that option is slash. Okay, in terms of navigation, we have a few options. By default, you can move your station right and left, up and down, by pressing Ctrl and Alt and moving your mouse. You can also do the same thing by holding down the scroll wheel button. If you want to rotate your station, you can press Ctrl and Shift and hold down the left button of your mouse. You can also do the same thing by holding down the right button of your mouse. If you want to zoom in and out, you can press Shift and the left button of your mouse. By dragging your mouse forward, you will zoom in, and by dragging your mouse backward, you will zoom out. The same thing can be done by using the scroll wheel. If you are used to the navigation control of another software, you can change RoboDKs to fit you better. Just go in the main menu, click Tools and Options. In the General tab, you can choose between 7 popular software. By default, Katia's controls are activated. Next, let's look at the station tree. We have the target one. Targets are simply positions to reach with the robot. If I click on it, the robot will move to that specific position. Just over it, you can see the reference frame. If I double click on it, we can see the actual value of the coordinate system. X, Y, Z, roll, pitch, and yaw. RoboDK will always display the appropriate Euler angles, but if you want, you can change the Euler format for the quaternion format used by ABB. In this list here, you have a few options to work with. If we go back to the robot screen, I can press and hold Alt, and now you can use your mouse to move the reference frame. As you can see in the right window, the value of the reference frame changes as I move the frame. I can also let go of Alt and click here in the toolbar. The result is the same. Okay, last thing. If you ever change a few settings in RoboDK and you want everything to go back to default, you just have to go in the main menu, click Tools and Options. At the bottom of the window, you can click on Set Default Settings. Every setting will go back to its original value. Okay, that's pretty much everything for RoboDK's basic guide. I really hope it was helpful. In the next video, we will learn to create a simple station with a robot, a few objects, and a custom tool. That being said, have a good day, guys.